We're going to begin our discussion in terms of ossification. And ossification is just a fancy word for bone development. So how does the bone develop in utero? And just a warning, well, ossification is traditionally or historically probably the most difficult component of the skeletal system in terms of understanding. So really take your time, rewatch these videos in order to get a good understanding of how bone actually develops. Bone starts to develop around the sixth week of embryonic development. So if you've ever been pregnant or know someone that's pregnant, you'll be like, oh, bones are starting to form fairly early on. And what's actually happening is you're having the creation of what's referred to as a mesenchymal skeleton. And this term mesenchyme or mesenchymal will come up over and over again as you talk about different organ systems. This is basically the embryonic connective tissue. So a lot of the connective tissues of the body are going to start through this embryonic or mesenchymal component. So that's what's actually starting to develop in the sixth week of in utero. And then it'll kind of break up into two main types of ossification. You'll have intramembranous ossification and endochondral ossification. Intramembranous is going to have the complete replacement of that mesenchymal skeleton with bone. Okay, so it's fairly easy in terms of it. Now the endochondral, you'll have an additional step. You'll start with the mesenchymal skeleton, then you're gonna have the development and the growth of a cartilage model, and then bone will replace that cartilage model. So you have this additional step when you're talking about endochondral ossification. And you see right here, you have this root chondre, which indicates cartilage. Now we're gonna focus in terms of this presentation in the intramembranous ossification. And this is, like I said, this is going to be the least complex, but actually most bones of the body actually form through the endochondral ossification. The other examples that form through intramembranous are flat bones of the skull, so the skull cap. Also important in terms of your fontanelles, and fontanelles are another, you colloquially refer to these as your soft spots. So you remember, touch the top of a baby's head, you have these soft spots. These are going to change into bone eventually through intramembranous ossification. Most of your facial bones, so bones associated with the anterior portion of the skull. Your mandible, which is your lower jaw, so the movable part of the skull, and the medial part of the clavicle. And your clavicle is colloquially referred to as your collarbone. So this medial portion of your clavicle forms through intramembranous ossification. So what is this? How does this actually go from that mesenchymal skeleton to the hard bone that we know? And what will actually happen is you'll have those cells, those mesenchymal cells, start to cluster around an area where the bone will eventually form in the juvenile. And what you'll have is you'll have the differentiation of these cells into these osteogenic cells, which will eventually form into or change into osteoblasts. And remember, these are those bone-forming cells that we've been discussing over and over again. So kind of right in the middle of where that bone's going to form, you'll have the development of this ossification center. And you can see these osteoblasts populating this region right here. Also importantly, what else do we have going on? We have to have blood supply for this to actually work. So you have to have a blood supply move into the area to cause the differentiation of these cells. Then you're going to have what's referred to as calcification. And before I move any further, I want to talk about the difference between calcification and ossification. Ossification is the overarching term for bone development. Calcification, a lot of time, is utilized to indicate when the bone actually hardens. A lot of times we use calcification only to indicate pathological bone hardening. But a lot of times you'll see it used interchangeably with ossification. It's actually a component or a portion of ossification. So what's happening is you had those osteoblasts in the ossification center. It's going to be secreting that extracellular matrix. And remember, when it does that, it traps that cell in there, and you have those osteocytes, or the mature cells. So you have the calcification, or the hardening of bone. Now, with that, you're going to still have osteoblasts in that area, so you have the continuous development of new bone, you'll have the osteoclast breaking down the old bone, and you're going to have the formation of those trabeculae, or those spicules of bone, if you remember from the previous presentation. So development of trabeculae, and if you remember the types of bones that are being formed by intramembranous ossification, so those flat bones of the skull, you're going to have the medial clavicle. Those are made up of almost exclusively spongy bone. So that's what's happening here. You're having development of those trabeculae of the spongy bone. Also in utero, as well as in juveniles, you're going to have that red bone marrow populating these spaces within. So you're going to have that red bone marrow that's forming red blood cells. So very important in terms of that. The last step of intramembranous ossification is the development of the periosteum, so that outside connective tissue layer. So that's going to be the very last thing that happens, and importantly, you're still going to have that layer of osteoblasts in between the actual bone and the periosteum. So you can see that in this visual here, these osteoblasts. It won't look exactly like this, of course, but just in terms of the illustration. So that's it in terms of intramembranous ossification. You're going to go from the mesenchymal skeleton, or that embryonic connective tissue skeleton, directly into bone. So in terms of the bones mostly of the skull. So the next presentation, we're going to talk about the type of ossification that occurs in most of the bones of the body, particularly the long bones, and that's endochondral ossification. Endochondral ossification, if you recall, has an extra step, so the growth of that hyaline cartilage model that will eventually be replaced by bone.